myself, I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year, stole many a man's soul of faith. I was around when Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain. Me damn sure the pilot washed his hands and sealed his face. Pleased to meet you, hope you guess my name. But what's puzzling you is the nature of my game. Stuck around St. Petersburg when I saw it was a time for a change. Killed the Tsar and its ministers, Anastasia screamed in vain. I rode a tank, held a generous...
I am Lucifer.
Okay, define Lucifer for me.
Pure, virtuous, wholesome, innocent individual that's out to help people.
Lucifer is?
Yeah.
Say that again. Lucifer is a pure, holy...
Virtuous.
Now, see the Lucifer that God created?
That's the same one.
Oh, man, this is great. I'm going to put this on the internet.
God bless you,
Amen.
Brother.
Because that's exactly what the Shriners and Masons teach, is that Lucifer is light. Okay, tell me about Jesus. Who is Jesus?
He's my leader.
Is he the Son of God?
Yes, he is.
Is he the only worshipful master?
Yes.
See, this is what a Mason confesses, is that Lucifer is light.
Why do you still do it? Why are you still out here?
Well, it goes back to the destiny thing. I mean, I made a bargain with it, you know, a long time ago, and I'm holding up my end.
What was your bargain?
To get where I am now.
Should I ask who you made the bargain with?
with the chief commander.
On this earth?
And this earth, and then in the world we can't see. I don't know how I got to write those songs.
What do you mean you don't know how?
Well, those early songs were like almost magically written. There's magic to that. And it's not Siegfried and Roy kind of magic, you know, it's a different kind of a penetrating magic.
I think that this is significant, and something really big has been revealed here. Something we've found at the end of this trail of breadcrumbs, which started at a small pizza shop a month ago and led us all the way to the Vatican. Anyway, go out there and decide for yourselves. I don't want to tell anyone what to believe. At the end of the day, you have to judge for yourself. It's really the only way to always stay objective and find the answers. But you might say, what about that 10-ton bronze statue that's seated behind the Pope, where, as the Vatican states, Christ has been resurrected from a nuclear apocalypse or a nuclear bomb? To which I would say, this, I believe, is a direct corruption of symbolism. That is, they've taken the former Catholic symbolism of Jesus Christ, and they've displayed it in a corrupted manner, therefore corrupting its meaning. This is just not the way that you display Jesus Christ in any kind of Christianic religious order. You don't display Jesus Christ with massive wings on his back, rising up from an atomic apocalypse. You just don't do this. Look at representations of Christ from the past, just to compare. Take a look. Now you can see that there's just a huge, vast difference here. Something is profoundly wrong. I mean, this statue, which weighs 10 tons, just looks like some massive thing, like a boss from some video game or something from some horror movie. You just don't display Christ like this. And also note on this, Christ appears to have massive wings on his back. Half of his face also looks like it's missing, like he's been heavily damaged by the blast. Is this really how you display Jesus Christ? Ask yourself that. You don't even have to be religious. Just look at history and compare. So what is happening? Well, I don't know, but I'm going to continue to dig. You can be sure of that.
Look Nella chiesa non esiste il fai da te. Talk like an angel, but I got mine. You're the devil in disguise, or yes you are, devil in disguise. You fool me with your kisses, you cheated and you schemed. Heaven knows how you lied to me, and not the way you seem. Walk like an angel, talk like an angel, but I got wise. You're the devil in disguise. Oh yes, you are.
Said in thy heart, I will ascend into heaven, I will exalt my throne above the stars of God, I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north, I will ascend above the heights of the clouds, I will be like the Most High.
This is a quote that struck such a huge chord among so many people in such a short time, but many do now expect him to get down to business and start tackling the very sensitive issues of reform and cleanup of the church.
Audience hall from the back, where the back audience was seated, it really did take my breath away, since what was revealed was this right here. That is a giant, massive reptilian face shaped into the direct architecture. Everything from the slits in the eyes to the scales to the fangs, there was no mistake about it. But what's behind this hinted symbolism? And what can we see or glean if we dig deeper? Well, number four, look at where the Pope is seated. We see him here from the back of the hall. That is in fact seated in the mouth of the serpent or reptilian, in the very mouth. This is symbolic of the Pope being the voice of the serpent, in fact speaking the serpent's words to the audience. This might well shake your faith, that is if you're a Catholic, which I was. I actually went to Catholic school myself and was an altar boy. But here you can see it in plain view. Clear symbolism, clear evidence that something here is extremely wrong. This image hasn't been photoshopped. This is real. This is built right into the architecture that was designed by those within the Pope's inner sanctum. But there is more symbolism. For this though, we have to go outside. Number three. Do you see anything strange here? You're looking at the hall itself. Do you see anything weird? Well, if you look carefully, it looks like the head of a giant snake. Can you see it now? In fact, it's almost unmistakable. You can see the snake's muzzle at the front and you can see its eye. It just looks like a snake. To me, this is yet more connective symbolism that what's going on inside matches the outside. Because since here we can see serpentine architecture with ease. Number two, let's head back inside and look at what the Pope himself sees. If the Pope is seated where he is, what does he see? Well, he sees a giant serpent with eyes once again. The audience is symbolic of almost the serpent's meal, and the Pope is not preaching to the audience under this symbolism, but the giant god-like reptilian creature himself. Why? Because this is what the Pope sees. Can you imagine that when they were designing this, that they designed this all by mistake, that this is some kind of high anomaly? No, because they spent literally years on the designs. They definitely would have known what the Pope would have seen from where he was actually speaking. Also, what the audience was seeing. So this is very strange and it raises some serious questions. What is going on in the hall? Number one. But the biggest clue, the biggest symbolism that tells us something is really, really wrong here is in fact what is missing from the hall, not what is inside it. Do you know what that is? Here is a clue. Now, think of the heart of Christianity and think of what symbol it has and think of what you do not see in this hall. You do not see any of it. That's right. There is no Christian cross. There is no cross in the entire building, at least no large statue, wall hanging, or anything. There's no other real Christian symbolism either. There's no Virgin Mary. There's no Joseph the carpenter. There is indeed nothing anywhere. All of these symbols are missing.
Esto significa appartenere alla Chiesa. Ricordatevi bene, essere cristiano significa appartenenza alla Chiesa. Il nome è cristiano, il cognome è appartenenza alla Chiesa.
My little girl,
that says, fool me once.
Shame on.
Shame on. Shame on you. You fool me, we can't get fooled again.
Why is there a Vatican observatory run by Vatican astronomers in the state of Arizona? Learn why these Vatican astronomers are involved with Project Lucifer using a special infrared camera attached to the most powerful telescope on Earth that peers into deep space searching for aliens and UFOs.
Initial instrumentation includes twin blue and red cameras for wide field imaging, as well as nulling interferometry capabilities to spot distant planets, advanced spectroscopy devices, and a near-infrared imager and spectrograph called Lucifer.
Globalize it, like Peter Tosh said, legalize it. World girls and boys hear the bass and the treble. Rumble in the speakers and it make you wanna rebel. Throw your hands up, take it to another level. And you never, ever, ever make a deal with the devil. Yeah, fire. Never send you an omen. Revolution never come with a warning. Never send you an owner.
Czar and its ministers, Anastasia, screamed in vain. I rode a tank, held a general's rank, when the blitzkrieg raged and the bodies stank. Pleased to meet you, hope you guess my name. Oh yeah.